and I know you made the team, the Gold Cup team as an alternate, and now all of a sudden you've boosted that into being a regular call-up. Discuss the momentum that you feel, and maybe not regular, but this is your second consecutive time. How do you feel what do you want to take from that last camp and move forward into this camp?
I think the difference is the set of confidence. Greg has really instilled in me the confidence that I needed to kind of make that Gold Cup run, be able to play, and, from being the last guy called in the camp to playing the Gold Cup final, against, Mexico, one of the biggest game of my life. I think that's super important coming into these games. Greg is continually giving me confidence. My teammates, veterans on the field, John Brooks, even though they're young, Weston McKennie, people like that, they're giving me the confidence to kind of step up and be able to play these games, even at such a young age.
Reggie, you called it a revenge match, straight up. Mm-hmm. Some people have been hesitant to call it a revenge match since the circumstances are obviously different. How can you see it that way?
I think it's a sense of loss. Right after that Gold Cup final, it kind of struck me on the plane back that you may never get that chance again, to play in that game, to play against a team like that, in a setting like that, in an environment like that. And that's why these feelings are still kind of harbored inside of everyone. We're going to come out there and give it our all. And this is we've learned from that game. We've studied it. We know what we did wrong. We know what we can adapt to make the game better for us. And, I think this is going to be very, very important coming into this game. So it's going to be an emotional tie back to that game. And unfortunately, that taste, we lost it and it happened. But, this time around, it's going to be different.
Does Mexico have something that the U.S. doesn't?
No, there's nothing different. The game just played out in their favor. They had chances, they put them away, and that's simple. I believe we have just as much of talent as they do. It's just going to come down to who plays better, and, it's going to be us this time.
There's no trophy on the line this time. How intense do you expect this match to be, given that it's a friendly compared to the one you played a couple months ago?
It means just as much. If there was a trophy involved or if there wasn't, we're working on changing the way America views soccer. And, every step, every game is an opportunity to do that. So, this game we're going to play just as we would if it was the World Cup final or the Gold Cup final. It's going to be the same. And, we're going to give it everything we have.
You're one of a few FC Dallas guys, homegrowns. As you mentioned, you had that taste with the Gold Cup, but now Paxton gets his first feel of this camp. Have you spoken to him leading into it and maybe what to expect? And I'm sure it obviously feels nice to see him go from the U-20s and that opportunity to now getting this feel.
Yeah, the impact FC Dallas has had over, at least four people at camp. Everyone has at least touched the FC Dallas Academy. I think it's five, actually, that have been in the FC Dallas Academy at one point. I think that's, super important that, FC Dallas, they have an imprint on, players like this. So I've been trying to get Paxton ingrained to the national team system and everything. I offered to room with him. Josh Sargent's pissed off at me because of that. But, I really wanted to integrate him and give him, the most success he could have possible with the national team because, I really do believe that he's the future, people like that, with the talent, the amount of talent that he has. I think it's really important to get them settled quick and give them the confidence that they need.
You see him on a daily basis, obviously every day in training and games. And what is it about him, maybe this year with his game, where it seems like he's taken a couple steps up the ladder?
I think it's definitely different from the beginning of the year, coming from not starting to, becoming one of the star players for FC Dallas, and becoming, an MLS All-Star and one of the best players in MLS. It's just, it's a process. And I think, he's really climbed up that ladder. He's starting to, really build his resume, for soccer. So I think that's really important. He's really developing into quite the player in this national team. And it's just the next step for him.
Playing Mexico, a Mexico team, playing them again, second game in a row. It's been a few months, but they're going to be a different squad. Could argue a stronger squad with the attack that they're going to bring in. How much you look forward to that challenge? You guys look forward to that challenge of what's probably going to be a more dangerous attack even than you saw in the vocal.
For us, it's the same name, same game. It's Mexico, and we're going to play just as we would any other game. But, obviously they do have different names up there and different, attacking profiles. And obviously we're going to study them and prepare the most we can for them. But, obviously they have a deep, deep pool of talent. So, we're always ready to adapt and, form our game on the way we want to play and not, kind of hesitant going into the game. So I think, the confidence we have going into this game is going to be very important. And Greg's going to, really give us what we need for this game.
This camp feel like it's a younger group than you had at the Gold Cup. Does that vibe of a younger group in this group?
Yeah, the average age, you know, it's pretty young for this camp, and I think you know, Greg's really trying to get people situated and, you know, get into the concept of national team. You know, people have different paths, different timelines, but the youth is coming, and the youth wave for U.S. is coming. So, you know, we've got a lot of talent and a lot of deep pool of talent that's coming through. So I'm really excited, you know, see Serginho Dest play, to see Paxton play. You know, I'm super excited for those guys because I know, you know, when they get their opportunity, they're going to do great. Yeah, I know. I feel like I'm having gray hairs in the back of my head at 21 years old. I don't know why, but you know, I'm always excited for this youth.